Probiotics have been a key component in restoring my own gut health. I really didn't start getting better until I was drinking sauerkraut juice, which shifted over to water kefir, both of those containing similar strains of bacteria, mostly lactobacillus, some bifidum, saccharomyces, and streptococcus. If you're unfamiliar with kefir, it's a symbiotic culture of yeasts that consume macronutrients, typically sugar, producing those strains of bacteria. It's kind of like a sourdough culture almost. And we did a video on dairy kefir a year or so ago, but the goals of consuming any probiotic food tend to be in unison. In order for your microbiome to be healthy, you have to have a balance of these different types of bacteria and yeasts. It just so happens that the bacteria contained in probiotic foods is typically what's low in your gut when you're having issues, whereas the overgrowth types, the bad bacteria like Candida, H. pylori, aren't contained in these probiotic foods. You can take all the antimicrobials you want, bomb out your gut bacteria, even antibiotics, but if you don't repopulate consistently with the right type of bacteria, your imbalance will simply come back. Water kefir is similar to dairy kefir in a sense they have comparable probiotic strains, but the water kefir is consuming sugar and the dairy kefir consumes the lactose, the proteins, the fats, and the milk. So the strains of bacteria are slightly different, but overarching, those positive strains that we mentioned earlier are contained in both. And water kefir is important because it's the only probiotic, to my knowledge, that most people can tolerate. You don't have to worry about a dairy allergy, and you certainly don't have to chug sauerkraut juice. Think of the water kefir grains consuming sugar as a cow consuming grass. The kefir grains turn the sugar into B vitamins, beneficial bacteria, even vitamin C, and also making the minerals in the sugar, molasses, whatever you're putting in there, more available to your body. And I really think it's one of the healthiest things you can drink. You know, just like a cow turns grass into beef, something that humans can't really eat, into an incredibly nutritious food packed with B vitamins, minerals, and protein. So not only are you getting those nutrients, those bacteria that help you balance, the bacteria will actually digest any sugar you consume, you know, turning it into those vitamins and nutrients for your body. You know, that's why someone with a healthy gut is seemingly unaffected by sugar, whereas it wreaks havoc on many others. This can be broken down into four categories of what your goals are. One could be, you know, reactivating the kefir grains if they were dried out, if they were dormant. Two is the first fermentation, making the actual water kefir. Three is a second fermentation, which is optional, but that's where you can add flavorings, increase the probiotic content. And a fourth would be, you know, multiplying the kefir grains, basically just feeding them with a bunch of sugar. Four ingredients. Of course, the water kefir grains, which I will have available on Frankie's Free Range Foods. And this is gonna be 4 ounces, which is enough to make 1/2 gallon of water kefir. Hopefully, I have enough to go around for you guys. And we have molasses, everything organic, you know, removing as many chemicals as possible. These are very high in minerals, and the kefir needs minerals as part of their diet, so that's where they're getting this from. It's not necessary to use this in every single fermentation, but the initial one you do, and then the secondary fermentation never needs molasses, only the first one. And then cane sugar, which is what the bacteria is basically turning into nutrients. This is like the grass for the cow. This is the bulk of what the kefir is consuming. And then you want a high quality filtered water. I'm using Gerolsteiner today, which has a high calcium content. So, you know, this end water kefir is going to be incredibly high in calcium, magnesium, minerals, beneficial probiotic bacteria. It's going to be a super nutritious drink that can't really be replicated. And all we have to do is combine these and let them sit for a few days. So for 1/2 gallon of water kefir, you want 4 ounces of the kefir grains, which should be about what I have in this jar. Then we want 4 ounces of sugar, so equal parts kefir and sugar, and then 1 tablespoon of the molasses. So then we're gonna fill this to the top with water because this is a 1/2 gallon jar. Now I'm using carbonated water, but the fermentation will actually carbonate the drink itself. So this can kind of make it extra fizzy. The only requirement for the water is that it's not chlorinated or fluoridated because that would actually kill the bacteria, but obviously you want the highest quality water possible. Let me close this jar up. You can tighten it depending on how fizzy you want it to be. And then at the bottom here, you see there's, you know, everything we put in, the sugar, the key for the molasses. You just kind of want to shake it up and incorporate it. And then this is going to sit for 48 to 72 hours, depending on the temperature of where it is. It has to be at least like 55, 60 degrees, so you definitely don't want this somewhere cold. And after about 48 hours, this is what you get. You can see it's fizzy. Everything's pretty much dissolved at the bottom. You can see the kefir grains, but you know, there's not really any sugar or molasses left. And the kefir grains are, you know, a lot bigger. They've grown, so to speak. So this is water kefir that's technically ready to drink. And when you taste this, you shouldn't taste any sweetness because the kefir ate the sugar. So if it still tastes a little sweet, it just hasn't gone long enough. And then if this goes another day or two, you know, the flavor will get even stronger. But the bacteria is at its peak around, you know, the 3 to 5 day mark. After that, the bacteria does start dying. So there is kind of like a window where you want to drink this. And then we take that water kefir and we put it in another jar with whatever flavorings, sugar you want. So in this case, I put half water kefir, half apple juice, and I put some lemons, limes, and ginger in here. And this is like a really, really delicious probiotic drink. There's some, you know, bacteria and yeast sitting at the bottom here. You can tell that's not sugar or anything else. And this is where the real experimenting comes in. After you get that water kefir done, you know, the amount of juice you add, the amount of sugar you add, the amount of flavorings you add, you kind of have to mess around with that. I don't know if you guys can hear this fizzing. It really is a nice carbonated soda. And if you make this the right way, it's more delicious than soda. This would be perfect for kids. And it doesn't even have any sugar. Of course, if there was a little sugar left and it wasn't completely eaten, this would be even more delicious, literally tasting like soda. So I just used like bottled biodynamic apple juice. I do actually have some raw apples that I have to juice in my garage and then start using the raw apple juice, which is gonna make like a ginger lemon apple cider kefir, which is so tasty, so good. So if you don't enjoy the taste of this, you did something wrong. Like the water kefir on its own actually tastes pretty good. But if you do this right with the right flavorings, the right amount of sugar added to refeed the bacteria, the right juice, it's really, really delicious and tasty. And you're keeping your gut microbiome in balance by drinking it. So I've been having this instead of water with most of my meals. I've been feeling a lot better. I think if anyone's having gut issues, this is a key component of an antimicrobial probiotic regimen to get things back in check. Hopefully sometime in the future, I'll be able to sell the actual kefir to you guys because it is like kind of like difficult. And you know, my parents are going to kill me. I got like 10 jars on the counter. It's ridiculous. But for now we just have the kefir grains. Hopefully that's enough just to get you guys started. So if you want those Frankie Syringe foods, I'm sure you can find water kefir grains elsewhere, but the ones that we're going to have are definitely active. They were just used. So that's that. Thank you guys for joining me today. If you could please drop a like on the video, leave a comment down below. Make sure to subscribe so that YouTube can unsubscribe you next week. And definitely click the notification bell so they don't notify you of my videos. Frank-Shafano.com for all of my businesses. And we'll probably do a live stream later, so check out the channel Frank Tufano. I'll see you guys for tomorrow's video.